But here, the owner's wife was worried. Was the old man's arrival was for the good or for the worst? Gradually, it rose to such a pitch that there was no land left in the village. And now, the quarrel sucked in all the people to either of the groups. He built a big mansion and he appointed few people who can praise him. Hello everyone, I'm Babita Tamaya, lecturer, Department of English, Vidyashram Pre-University College, Mysuru. In my previous session, I had discussed about the poem, When You're Old. And it is a depicted love story where the author's beloved will not accept his love. Today, I'll be discussing about the prose, The Gardener. It is a short story, Thottadavanu, which is translated into English version by H.S. Raghavendra Rao. It is believed that among all species, human beings are considered the most intelligent. He can reach to any extent to fulfill his desire. Today, we are going to learn one such chapter where human beings has no limits and he can reach to any extent to conquer his fulfillment. This chapter has a great message to the entire mankind. Here is the author, P. Lankesh. P. Lankesh is an Indian writer and journalist who wrote in Kannada. After graduating with an honors degree in English from Central College at Bengaluru and studied his Masters of Arts degree in English from Maharaja College at Mysuru. And his first work was Kere Neerannu Kerege Chelli. It's a collection of short stories which was published in 1963. This was followed by several collections of short stories and poetry. There were three novels, critical essays, translations, as well as several plays and films. Let's see what the story is all about, The Gardener. When the author is traveling towards Chennaraiyapatna, it falls in the boundaries of Hassan district. There he finds an old man near the coconut grove of Chennaraiyapatna. The author describes him in such a way, how he actually looked like. He was a tall figure and his hairs are gone grey. He had a long beak-like nose and a strong muscular arm. In one hand, he had a spade which is used to tend the coconut trees, and in the other hand, a newspaper was tucked under his arm. He was a laborer, philosopher, overseer. All the three characters are rolled into one. So here, the owner of the plantation needed a person exactly like him, exactly like the old man. He was in search of such a person where he can look after his coconut grove. And he has walked hundreds of miles and he has reached that place. Later on, a few words was exchanged between the old man and the plantation owner. Here, the old man was well versed in agriculture as well. He could understand the problem of the workers. There was a petty theft, but after the arrival of the old man, everything was stopped. The income of the owner gradually improved. There was a lot of improvement in the owner's land after the arrival of the old man. But here the owner became lethargic and he shied away from his work. He was not showing any interest towards his work, but he had acquired few friends in his town as well as the neighboring village also. He started to cultivate a bad habit. Bad habit, it means to say that he had an extramarital affair also. After the arrival of the old man, the owner earned a lot of fame and money. But here, the owner's wife was worried. Was the old man's arrival was for the good or for the worst? Because leisure and luxury leads him to adultery and obtain verses. One day, the old man met the owner's wife and he behaved that he knows each and everything about her plight. About her plight in the sense, about the owner, what the owner's wife was thinking about. He behaved as if he knows each and everything. The old man smiled at her and offered her a tender coconut. After offering a tender coconut, he sat under the embankment of the well. But here, the owner's wife, she could not move anywhere and she did not have any alternative to do. And even she sat there next to the old man near the embankment of the wall. After that, what did the old man do? The old man started to narrate a story. And what was the story all about? He begins the story saying that there was a man called Tamanna and he had 10 acres of wetland. He had everything. He had a house, people and supporters to help him. He had everything, but there was a rivalry. But the most important among all his possessions was his rivalry, Sangoji or Basavaya. Sangoji is Basavaya, is one and the same. There was an enmity between Tamanna and Basavaya. In the beginning, it was a healthy competition between Tamanna and Basavaya. But how did it go on? What was the competition between the two here? If one bought 10 acres of land, the other acquired the same. If one had 10 friends, the other admires 15. So here there is a difference between the friends and admirers. Friends who will stay with you forever, that is known as the friendship. But admirers, they'll support you only for such an extent. So there was a competition between friends and admirers here. If Tamanna bought 4 acres, Basavaya bought 8 acres of land. And if one acquired 10 friends, the other admires 15. Gradually, it rose to such a pitch that there was no land left in the village. Whatever the land was there in the village, everything was occupied by Tamanna and Basavaya. But Tamanna had 1,000 acres of land and Basavaya had 800 acres of land. Tamanna had 200 acres of land more, where Basavaya could not tolerate this. So he sends one of his supporters to ask Tamanna to sell his 200 acres of property. But Tamanna was not ready. Instead of that, he was ready to buy all the property which was belonged to Basavaya. When Tamanna did not agree to sell his property, Basavaya forcibly acquired his 200 acres of property and put a fence around it. Here, Tamanna could not tolerate this invention. And now the quarrel sucked in all the people to either of the groups. So the supporters of Tamanna says that you have 3 ways to get your land back. One is you can take the help of the court, or you can go to the police, or we ourselves will help you out to get your land back. But here, Tamanna was in search of another method where he could annihilate Basavaya. But what was the another method here? Tamanna came up with an idea of composing ballads. Composing ballads, he composed and sung. He did not write, he composed and he sung the songs. So here Tamanna started to compose the ballads and he started to sing. So now the rivalry moves from visible domain to invisible and extract domain. First, it was a healthy competition, but later on it turns towards be a rivalry between the two. When Tamanna started to sing ballads, Basavaya had no answer to this. Even he also tried to sing, but he couldn't. Then he decided to perform into his agriculture tasks more. But for that also, Tamanna did not have any answers. So what did Tamanna do later on? So Tamanna's reputation started to spread worldwide, where Basavaya could not tolerate this. So his song started making a mention of Basavaya's cruelty and meanness. Critics started analyzing and translating his songs, and thus they earned their share of fame. But here Basavaya was helplessly watching all these things. Consumed by anger, he encroached more into Tamanna's land. But Tamanna did not notice any of these activities. He was felicitated as the best poet of the times. Now Basavaya is shrunk in humiliation. So he decided to fill his house with all kinds of material wealth. He built a big mansion and he appointed few people who can praise him. And he also decorated himself with gold, diamond and other precious stones. But the people who came to his house said that you have everything, but one thing is missing, that was the books of Tamanna. Not only this, therefore Basavayya started inviting the scholars, poets and musicians to his place and thought this was his way of investing his home with meaning. One day Basavayya came to know that Tamanna was ill, that Tamanna was sick, and Basavayya found the means of surpassing Tamanna. And now you're sitting on my shoulders. Now it's the time for me to put an end for each and everything. He says that Tamanna's disease was Basavayya's health. This is what he feels when he got to know that Tamanna was sick. When Basavayya got to know that Tamanna was sick, at this time what Tamanna did? Tamanna had thought of yet another plan or method how he can punish Basavayya. That was the death of Tamanna. So here, what did Tamanna thought? That Basavayya would go on an offering of stiff competition to him. Now Tamanna decided to separate the songs from his body. If there is no relation between the songs and his own flesh and blood, this is how Tamanna thought about. Then later Tamanna realizes that it is the nature of mankind. So here, man is not happy with whatever requirements he has. He tried to occupy more and more. He wants to conquer more and more. So these are the lines here. Man needs wealth, education, art, and many more things. He needs all those things, but even then he is not satisfied with these things. He tries to conquer more and more. Man's wants are unlimited. He wants to acquire more and more. That is what has happened here in the story. So here, the man lives for some kind of vulnerable vengefulness. He is not happy with what he has. And here the old man says to the owner's wife that it is not a real story and I had heard it somewhere. He says that whatever the story I have told now, whatever the narration I have did till now, it is not a real story. I heard it from someone else. That is what the old man says to the owner's wife. And he says that I'm just an old man. After a particular age, man loses his name. His age becomes important. So what becomes important? His age becomes important and his fame vanishes in the thin air. That is what he says. Until you're alive, what does the old man says? What is important here? Age is very important, not your fame. The fame will be vanished in the air once you're dead. That is what he says to the owner's wife. And he says that I'm an old man in your garden. He says that I'm an old man in your garden. I'm your servant. I conceived the story of Tamanna and Basavayya. So whom does I hear? I conceived the story of Tamanna and Basavayya. When all of a sudden Russia told America, we are not going to fight anymore. We are not the sole enemies. So I here is the author, that is P. Lankesh. He is very intelligent here. He says that he is comparing Russia and America to Tamanna and Basavayya. So why he is comparing it to Tamanna and Basavayya? Because the Russia and America, they had a cold war each and every time. So he is comparing it to Tamanna and Basavayya. When suddenly Russia says that we are not the enemies no more and we are not going to wage a war against each other. So the Americans will be shocked to hear this. The same thing happened here. Why he gives an example of this? Because Tamanna and Basavayya, they had a fight between, it was a tough competition and rivalry between the both. But when Basavayya got to know about Tamanna's ill, Tamanna thought that he might give a tough competition. So what did Tamanna do? Tamanna, he just gives out the songs and ballads from his body, and later he leaves the village and come out. Once he comes out, he will get to know that Basavaya is no more. He thought that, what does he think? What Tamanna thought? Tamanna thought that my death alone could destroy Basavaya, and he gave up everything and started off. Started off in the sense, he left the village and came out. So I can give one more example here. If your neighbor is troubling a lot, if they are troublesome, if they try to fight with you every time, what will you do to come out of this problem? You need to search a solution for this. So overnight, you sit, think and decide, and the very next morning, your neighbor would come, knock the door saying that, I'm sorry, let us hereafter, I'll not fight with you. What do you feel? Whole night, you didn't plan for the situation. But when he says that we are not enemies, I don't fight with you anymore, you'll be happy to hear. And in one way, you'll be happy to hear. And the other way, why this fellow is suddenly coming and saying that we are not going to fight with you anymore. So at last, what Tamanna says, I gave up everything. I had given up everything. And later I got to know that Basavaya had passed away. And now Tamanna feels that he has no reason to live anymore. That's what he feels at the end. And here, at last, what does the old man says? My name is Tamanna. So whatever the story the old man had told to the owner's wife was his own story. The old man, he himself is Tamanna. He says, my name is Tamanna. After his death, I had forgotten all my songs and ballads. I had given up everything. There is no reason to live anymore. That is what he says to the owner's wife. And why the story is narrated to the owner's wife? It's because your husband is flourishing today as a rich man. He is not amenable to any advice. Man is so complicated that till the day of his death. So here he says that man goes on living for some revenge or the other, confronting one challenge to the other, because the human wants are unlimited. He'll be not satisfied with whatever wants he has. At last, the author Pilanke says this, forgive me, unable to elaborate. I have told you whatever I felt as it is. I had seen this all in my dream. So what does the author says that? He says that because he couldn't elaborate the story. Whatever the story was told till now, it was a dream where he was fast asleep. He has seen it as a dream and it is narrated here as a story. But this story gives a very good message to the entire mankind. Here is the glossary. It's nothing out of the text. Please go through with these words and the meaning of the words and its meaning. So from this chapter, the weightage of this chapter is for 5 marks. You'll be having one question for 1 mark and one question for 4 marks. Put together, the weightage of this chapter is for 5 marks. In my next session, I'll be discussing about the poem To the Food from Its Child. Until then, stay home, stay safe, stay educated. Thank you.